Good morning, students. So today we are going to start after Diwali vacation the poem 3.1, the plate of gold. Okay, now if the poem it is told in a story manner, so that is known as the narrative poem. Okay, so this is a narrative poem, and mostly the narrative poems they are written in free verse. Now, what is the free verse? Means no rhyme scheme. Okay, it is free of the rhyme scheme, and there is no particular syllable maintained in each of the lines. So that is a free verse. Okay, so this poem, it is a narrative poem in the form of a story. It is a, okay, and it is written by, you see there already, James Henry Leigh Hunt. It is given at the back page, 59 page number. So you will get it there. So James Henry Leigh Hunt, he has told this story. And the story is, as you have heard from your grandparents, mother, father, in the younger age. So the same story here he is telling about a plate of gold. So without any rhyme scheme, and if you will go with the poem after just observing or seeing the poem, you will find out the first stanza, three lines, and then in the fourth line there is a short word. Okay, then again the next stanza, four lines are there, in the next stanza six lines, and in the next stanza, in this way the lines are also not in proper order in stanzas. So the free verse it is written, it is a form of a story. Now we will go with the poem itself. One day there fell in great Benares, as it is a story, so it has been started with one day. Okay, one day there fell in great Benares temple court a wondrous plate of gold. So what happened in the temple court? So a great plate of gold has fallen there, and whereon these words were writ. Many old English usage words are used in this poem. So writ means that is the written. Okay, to him who loveth best a gift from heaven thereat. Now listen here, the words are not arranged in a proper order, as in poem we will find out just not like the prose order, subject, verb, then object. So here you will find out there is no subject, and in the end the subject is given there, but rhyme scheme is not at all followed. To him who loveth best, again loveth, who God has given his love, who loveth best a gift from heaven thereat. So loveth means love. So there is, again this is the old English usage words, a gift from heaven, this plate of gold has fallen in the temple court. Thereat the priest made proclamation. So as this plate of gold was seen by the priest, sadhu, sangh, those who are working there in the temples, so he has declared, proclamation means a public statement was made by him. At the midday hour each day, let those assemble who for virtue deem their right to heaven's gift the best. So he made a public statement. So he considered that at the midday hour you will assemble here in the court, and those who have love towards the God, those who will show the most love towards the God, most loyal towards the God, to whom that plate of gold will be given. So this plate of gold is for that, the person who will show his love best towards the God. And we will hear the deeds of mercy done and so adjust. So what he decided, what was the proclamation? He decided that those who will show us their, whatever they have done, the deeds of mercy, the works of pity, sympathies, and helped others. So these works, if they have done properly, and so then we will adjudge. Adjudge means at that time we will consider and declare that he is the proper person, and to that person this plate of gold will be gifted. So this is a gift from heaven, this is a gift from God. So this proclamation was made by the priest. The news ran swift as light. So here as light means it is a simile, figure of speech. And you know, in the villages or in the temple court, when such proclamation is made, so the news ran swift as light. As light, the news will spread here and there. And soon every quarter came. Every quarter means here the corner. Every corner of that village came there. Nobles and munshis and hermits, scholars, holy men. Now nobles, the higher rank people also came there. The munshis, you know the munshis, those who are working in the king's court. So hermits, again the saints, they also came there. Scholars, the learned people came there. Holy men, the men who were very religious and believing in God, they also came there. And all renowned for gracious or for splendid deeds. So these all persons, they were very famous, well known, renowned means that is the well known persons for gracious and splendid deeds. They were very famous persons for something good they had done for the people. So these all came there, gathered there. Meanwhile, the priest in the solemn council sat and heard. So what the priest did, they were working as a judge there. So at that time, very seriously, they were hearing what the people were telling about their splendid and the holy deeds, which they were believing that they have done the best, and so that they could get this plate of gold. Meanwhile, the priest in solemn council sat and heard what each had done to merit best the gift of heaven, what each one has done to achieve this gift of heaven or to get this gift of heaven, and what each one has done for the worth of the people, for the good being of the people. So for a year, the claimants came and went. So for a year, this happened for a year, but because no one could get, because as they used to touch the plate of gold to receive it, as the priest judge it, and as they touch the plate of gold, it would change into the lead metal. So no one could get the plate of gold. So no one was so blessed with all the good deeds, and no one was blessed with the gift of heaven, that is the plate of gold. So for a year, the claimants means that is those who claim that though I am the right person and I should get this plate of gold. So all these claimants came there. 1 year this was going on. Came and went. Again, opposite words are used in a sentence. So this is antithesis. So we are finding that opposite words are there in the sentence. So this was going on for 1 year. At last, after a patient waiting of the worth of all. So after waiting for patiently, the priest and all the saints were waiting there. The priest bestowed the plate of gold on one who seemed the largest lover of the race. So at last the priest decided after 1 year, so now we should give someone. So they selected the one person and they decided now this plate of gold should be given to that person who seemed the largest lover of the race, whose whole estate within the year had been parted among the poor. So what he has done, he has given, parted means distributed among the poor. His whole estate was given by him to the poor people. So the priest thought that this is the best person to whom we could give the plate of gold. This man, all trembling with his joy, advanced to him. So this man, so he was very happy. He was so happy that from the thousands of the people I have been selected. So he was trembling, shaking there, and advanced to take the golden plate. When look, so as he advanced to take, as he touched the golden plate. So look, L-O word is there. So that is the look. Again, it is the old English usage word. Look, at his fingers first touch, it changed to beast, that is the basest lead. As he touched the plate of gold, it changed into the lead. So it didn't remain at all the plate of gold, it changed into the lead metal. All stood aghast. Aghast means what is that? Shocked. Everyone was shocked and horrified what happened to the plate of gold. But when the hapless claimant dropped it clanging on the floor, heaven's guerdon was again transferred to shining gold. So this hapless means unfortunate, after seeing this converted into the land, he dropped it on the floor. So as he dropped it on the floor, he saw that again it changed into a gold. So this was a miracle. Means the plate didn't belong to him. So for another 12 months sat he, priest and judge. So another 12 months the priest did the same thing. They sat and judged the persons. Thrice they awarded, thrice did heaven refuse again. 3 times they awarded. They selected a person and they were ready to give this plate of gold to that person. But 3 times the same happened. As those persons touched the plate, it changed into the lead metal. Meanwhile, a host of poor, maimed beggars in the street. Maimed means that is lame. A completely crippled man. Whoa, he was a beggar there. Lay all about the temple gate. He was there in the temple gate, as we see the beggars are there in the temple gates, in hope to move that love whereby each claimant hoped to win the gift. So he also thought, okay, now whom this plate will get? And for them it was, if gold be charity. So if someone will get the plate of gold, then they will also distribute something to us. For every pilgrim to the temple gate praised God. So every pilgrim, those who came in the temple, they will praise God, they will offer something to God as we also do it. So we offer something to God. That love might thus approve itself before the test. So in this way, they also gave something to others, something to God, offered many things. And they thought that in this way, we can show our love towards the God. And so coins rained freely in the outstretched hands. So what people, what they did, they started giving to all the beggars freely, whatever the coins were there, how many coins they needed, they started giving it freely only to get this plate of gold. But none of those who gave so much as turned to look into the poor, sad eyes of them that begged. But these all people gave all those coins into the temple yard. But no one looked towards the poor eyes of the beggar. So what they actually wanted, no one cared for them. They all came to the temple. They all gave the coins. They all gave all their wealth and everything to the temple, to the God there. But they didn't hear the voice of these poor beggars. So in this way, the 2 years passed, and now the second year had almost passed. So second year was also moving on, but still the plate of gold by whomsoever touch was turned to lead. But still the plate of gold, it was changing to lead when whomsoever the judges found, the priest found that he is the right person, it changed into a lead. At length, there came a simple peasant, not aware of that strange contest for the gift of God. So there came a simple peasant, a farmer, and he was not at all knowing about all this, what is going on, what is going on here. So he was not at all knowing. So the contest, what the contest is there, what the competition is there, to pay a vow within the temple. So he decided that he will go and just worship in the temple. As he passed along the line of shriveled beggars, so here he saw that all the dried up and the wrinkled-faced beggars were sitting there. So he paid attention towards them. All his soul was moved within him to sweet pity, and the tears welled up and trembled in his eyes. So when he saw these poor beggars, so at that time he sat there, he waited there, and tears came out that I am worshipping God, but these beggars, they are unhappy and they couldn't do any work, so I should help these poor beggars. Only that single peasant thought about it. Now by the gate, temple gate, there lay a poor, sore creature, blind and shunned by all. So there he saw a very poor creature. He was sitting there as a beggar, and he was blind, and he was avoided. Shunned means avoided, and he was rejected by all. But when the peasant came and saw the sightless face, and trembling, maimed hands, he could not pass, but knelt. But when the peasant came there, he saw that this man is blind and he's trembling there. And he's asking for something. He knelt and took both palms in his hand, softly said. So what the peasant did, he knelt down there, okay, on his knees. And he asked softly by taking both his hands in his own hands and asked, "Oh, thou," thou means again you, old English usage word, "my brother, bear thy troubles bravely." Whatever the troubles you are having, you face those troubles very courageously. God is good. Means God is good, and he will give you something more. Then he arose and walked straightway across the court and entered where they wrangled of their deeds of love before the priest. So then he arose and went straight to the court where this competition was going there. So here the peasant also came. He was not at all knowing about the competition, but only just he paid attention towards that beggars, and many beggars were sitting in the outside the temple. So he was feeling so sad. So he just told the beggars that they will also have the gift of the God. They will receive it. God is so great. A while he listened sadly, then had turned away, but something moved the priest who held the plate of gold to beckon to the peasant. So a while he listened sadly then. So he listened sadly what is going on here. But the priest, what he did, he listened sadly, and then he turned that plate of gold to beckon to the peasant. So he called out that peasant, "Come here and try to touch the plate of gold." So he came, not understanding, and obeyed, and stretched his hand and took the sacred vessel. he was not at all understanding what is going on because he didn't know about the competition or about this gift of heaven. So he came there and obeyed as the priest told him, and he stretched out his hand and he took the sacred means holy, the things which are given by the God or which is refers to the God, so that is the holy. He touched it. Lo, it shone with thrice its former luster. So look, lo means again the look. It was shining before also, but now three times the shining rose there and amazed them all, and all were really shocked. Three times the plate was shining. Son, cried the priest, rejoice, the gift of God is thine. So all the priest rejoiced there, son, you have done a miracle. This actually the gift, it is meant only for you. It is the God's gift. Thou lovest best, and God loves you the best here. And all made answers, it is well, and one by one departed. So all those who came for the competition, they understood now, really this gift belonged to only this peasant. It is well, and one by one departed. Departed means went away. But the peasant knelt and prayed, bowing his head about the golden plate. So when the peasant took that plate, and he bowed down and knelt and prayed, while over his soul, like morning, streamed the love of God. So over his soul, like morning, streamed the love of God. He understood that this is only God is good, and God will do something for the beggars. And this is the same way that God has given him the plate of gold, so that now he could help the poor beggars, those who are really in need. He could help those poor beggars. So he told that God is good, and God knows to whom he should give much alms. So that is the way, in this way, the peasant who loves the people made by the God, they are loved most by the God. So this is the poem about, we get a lesson that God doesn't love that what we offer to him in the temple, but what we do towards the mankind. God sees all those things and love to them best. Those who help the poor and the needy, and those who loves the things which are made by the God. Only, not only the human beings, but all the creatures, all the environment, the nature which is made by God. If we love these all things, then God loves us best. Yes. Have a good day, good time. Tomorrow we are going to discuss the grammar section of this lesson. Till then, bye everyone.